Yuri. It's my brother, Yuri. He's my big brother.
The fuck is that?
Ukraine. I was young, but I remember. Look, I start in Odessa, right? And then I work my way to the Crimean.
You're gonna be dead before you fucking reach Kiev. Come on, we're going home. Come on.
You fuck! You fucking fuck! You fucking fuck! Fuck is your problem?
Come on, B.
It's so nice to be home.
Yeah, we're gonna get you. Come on.
Vitaly, I need you to get out of the car. I promised our parents.
Please.
Vitaly, you're gonna have a great time. This is a top place. Two Ford models checked in last week, and that cute weather girl's been here since July.
Please. Please, Yuri. Good brother, Yuri.
Okay. All right.
Good brother.
All right, get out of the car. Okay. Get out of the car.
Those 45 years of mutual hatred between the East and the West had generated the highest weapons buildup in history. The Soviets had guns coming out of the demon hole, huge stockpiles, and now no enemy.
How many Kalashnikovs do you have?
40,000.
Is that a four? Doesn't look like a four to me. It's more like a one.
No, it's a four.
It's whatever we say it is, because no one else will know the difference. 10,000 Kalashnikovs for a battalion. Your stocks are dangerously depleted, Dmitri. You should order more from the factory.
Someone will work it out. What happens then?
We'll cut them in.
The end of the Cold War was the beginning of the hottest time in arms dealing. The arms bazaar was open. Guided missiles, unguided missiles, mortars, mines, armored personnel carriers, whole tank divisions. I even landed a squadron of helicopter gunships. The most sophisticated fighting machines, built for a war with America that never happened. Of all the weapons in the vast Soviet arsenal, nothing was more profitable than Avtomat Kalashnikova, model of 1947, more commonly known as the AK-47 or Kalashnikov. It's the world's most popular assault rifle, a weapon all fighters love. An elegantly simple 9-pound amalgamation of forged steel and plywood. It doesn't break, jam, or overheat. It will shoot whether it's covered in mud or filled with sand. It's so easy, even a child can use it, and they do. The Soviets put the gun on a coin. Mozambique put it on their flag. Since the end of the Cold War, the Kalashnikov has become the Russian people's greatest export. After that comes vodka, caviar, and suicidal novelists. One thing's for sure, no one was lining up to buy their cars.
All right, let me see your papers. No, put that away. Let me see your papers.
Yuri Orlov.
Mr. Orlov, always in the wrong place at the right time. We've met before. Off the coast of Colombia. What was the name of that freighter? I can't remember. Was it the Kono
or the Kristall?
The crew called that vessel a lot of names. None of them repeatable implied company.
Answer the question.
Oh, the new MP5. Would you like a silencer for that?
I need to see your papers.
You didn't knock with
Dimitri!
The end-user certificate for this aircraft states Burkina Faso. Nice. Very nice. Did you type this up yourself?
The helicopter's to be used on humanitarian missions.
Oh, so you're a humanitarian?
Oh, absolutely.
This is a military aircraft.
Not anymore.
Listen to the nephew!
What can they do with military hardware but convert it to civilian use? The only way you could die from this baby now is if a food drop hits you.
And this stuff over here, is that going to Burkina Faso as well?
But to a different client at a different address.
That's just a coincidence, is that it? Do you take me for a complete fucking fool?
Not complete, sir. And while I hesitate to tell you your job, I must point out that when shipped separately, the weapons and the aircraft both comply with the current Interpol trade standards and practices.
We both know that is an obscene bureaucratic loophole that's gonna be closed any goddamn day.
But it's not closed. And while certain people might interpret this cargo as suspicious, thank God we live in a world where suspicion alone does not constitute a crime, and where men like you respect the rule of law.
I was as guilty as sin, but Valentine couldn't prove it. And he was the rarest breed of law enforcement officer, the type who knew I was breaking the law, but wouldn't break it himself to bust.